Before the day begins, Lori and Monty give a few pointers on how to handle family drama.
Today I want to talk to you about how families get along in here. Not only are we trying to get the bride to find the dress of her dreams, we're also trying to get her families to merge.
True.
We're a family too.
Right.
And you two argue all the time, 24/7.
What's her fault? It's not mine.
And then puts me right in the middle. So see, think how the poor bride feels. We've got to make sure that everybody kind of gets along as best as we can.
That's something for consultant Flo to consider as she greets a bride bracing herself for a culture clash.
Where's my bride?
Right here.
My name is Staci Sweeney, and I'm from Knoxville, Tennessee. I am 26.
So who do you have with you?
My mother, my future mother-in-law, future sister-in-law, my cousin, my sister, and my two best friends.
Tell me a little bit about your wedding.
My wedding is going to be Hollywood-themed. My fiancé, Jason, and I are having our wedding at a theater. It's kind of a non-traditional venue. We're a blending of cultures. I come from a Christian background. He's Jewish, so we have totally different kind of families. But family is so important to both of us.
What type of style are you looking for?
Glitzy and...
glamorous?
Yeah, like low cut in the back. Really low cut in the back.
Ooh. Kind of sexy.
My concern is that you have that little tattoo on your shoulder.
So we have a tattoo.
It's a small tattoo on my shoulder.
My heritage is Irish, so I got the shamrocks tattoo on my back when I was 18. I really do love it, and it's a part of me.
I would like for it to be covered. In the Jewish religion, we don't have tattoos.
Our religion does not like you to desecrate your body.
It's shamrocks. It's her Irish heritage. What her tattoo back here represents.
My mom wants to defend me, but I really do want everyone to like the dress.
What's your budget for your dress?
$2,500.
Okay. Ready to go upstairs and start pulling some dresses?
Let's go!
When you have two families with such different cultural backgrounds, it's very important to find the middle ground here. This appointment could set the tone for their entire marriage.
So far, I don't see anything that would cover up that tattoo.
Learning to compromise starts today.
This one may cover the tattoo.
Let me show you another one.
I do like that one.
Now, will this show the tattoo?
Yep. That's my choice to try.
I'm here to make sure Staci gets what she wants and is not pressured to do anything that she does not want to do.
Since Staci is looking for something sexy, Flo puts her in mom's choice first, a strapless satin fit and flare.
I like this. Wow, that bodice looks really nice. You can see the curves. But then this dress is strapless. It's going to give my future mother-in-law a heart attack.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, I love that one.
I love the top.
I love the whole dress.
The tattoo is exposed.
Well, I don't think there's a thing wrong with it.
It looks like a dill pickle to me.
It does not look like a pickle. I felt like that really hurt Staci's feelings.
I really don't want to start my marriage off on the wrong foot with my mother-in-law. I'm starting to question, you know, if it's worth all of this, that maybe I should just cover the tattoo.
You want to talk pickle? This situation right here is a pickle.
Down in Alterations, a country bride arrives with doubts of her own.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Chrissy Hill. I'm 25. I'm from Batesburg, South Carolina, and I'm here to pick up my dress today.
So who'd you bring with you today?
Today I brought my bridesmaid, my maid of honor, and my other bridesmaids.
During their first visit to Bridals by Lori, tomboy Christy and her down-home family were clueless about wedding dresses.
Mind-boggling.
And to everyone's surprise, the blue jean and boot-wearing bride fell in love with a poofy princess ball gown.
Yeah, I hope I still like it.
You better.
I know. I'm Marion Thomas Corbett. He actually went and took out a loan so I could finish paying off my dress. He is a great man.
Here it is.
Wow.
How do you feel right now, looking at it?
I'm just still nervous about how fancy it is. This is too fancy.
Gorgeous.
You still like it?
I still like it.
Yay! I had this, like, in my head that it was gonna be this huge poofy thing. Like, oh my gosh, why did I pick this thing out? But yeah, I love it.
I'm really excited for my wedding. I'm getting more excited now. It's perfect.
Bride Staci is caught between a shamrock and a hard place.
The tattoo is exposed.
And the bride's mother wants the dress decision to be strictly Stacy's.
Don't think this is where you want to go starting out in a new marriage. I'm starting to question, you know, if it's worth all of this.
No closer to finding the wedding gown, the bride is just about ready to surrender.
It's very important to find the middle ground here. We've got to merge these two families together. I know just the dress.
Lori's choice is a one-strap ivory silk lace fit and flare.
I like this a lot.
I loved the one strap that it was lace. It was just perfect.
Wow. I like this one a lot.
Oh. I love this dress. I really do.
It covers your tattoo.
It was ridiculous that this one strap just happened to be on the side that my tattoo is on. It was kind of like divine intervention.
The strap, that's why she likes it so much.
I'm not gonna choose a dress based on my tattoo or not based on my tattoo. I would never buy a dress for that reason.
A scale of 1 to 10, what do you give it right now?
I think it's a 10. I really do.
Mom thinks she's losing this battle. I think it's time to make them forget what they're fighting about. It's time to jack her up.
I love it.
She is beautiful. And with the veil on, I have to say that tattoo is covered.
Look how you blended your whole family in this dress. This strap is for your new family, okay?
Oh, that's so sweet.
And then the strapless side of this is for your family. And then the veil's for all of us, because we all love it, right?
Yeah.
I love it.
It's a great feeling to please everyone and to be happy myself.
I love it.
Are you saying what to this dress?
I am saying yes to the dress. Yay!
I think it's amazing that my dress can be used as a tool to bring two families together, that everybody can feel like we're all one big family.
I always wanted her to make the decision, not because of what anyone else thought.
We're very, very happy.
Not only did we give the bride the gown of her dreams, we kind of sealed a relationship here.
I might be like Dr. Phil.
Woo! That was awesome. Dr. Lori. Mm-hmm.